All right. Hello, everyone. Hello. I'll give it a few seconds before we get started. So excited for everyone to be joining us today. All right. Hello, everyone. Thank you all so much for joining us for Alpha Epsilon Pi's weekly D'var Torah. My name is Michael Kagan. I serve as the Senior Associate of Global Student Leadership at Hillel International, and I'm a proud brother of the Sigma Delta chapter of the Alpha Epsilon Pi fraternity. I am so excited and honored to be welcoming you all to this weekly D'var Torah, in particular led by one of my longtime mentors, friends, and former colleagues, Phil Brodsky. Phil has been such an amazing inspiration, both within my early Jewish career and as someone who I look up to in career development and pursuing your passions in a meaningful and genuine way. So with that, I'm officially going to hand it over to Phil Brodsky, who's going to lead us in this weekly D'var Torah. And I want to wish everyone at the onset of this call a happy, healthy, and safe Shabbat Shalom. Phil, take it away.
Thank you, Michael. Thanks for that intro. It's so good to see you here today. Like you said, Michael, we worked together for many years at David Project and then Hillel, and we even had a Facebook show. So it's like a special edition Phil Friday here on the AEPi channel, which I'm excited about. I want to start today by noting that this is the first weekend of December, which means that this very hard, very tough and challenging year of 2020 is almost over. But before we turn the page toward 2021, we get to spend the next few weeks looking back on this past year and remembering all the time we spent praying for the millions of people that were impacted by COVID-19, enduring the stress and intensity of the presidential election in the United States, and empathizing for all those who experienced many kinds of loss over the last year. Loss of loved ones, loss of jobs, loss of seeing our friends and family in person on holidays. And I was one of those who lost their jobs earlier this year because of COVID. Thankfully, though, now Hanukkah arrives this upcoming week, and in doing so, it reminds us to look for the light in times of darkness. Therefore, we push ourselves to also remember the good times wherever we found them in 2020. For instance, we can remember those special times when we caught up with old friends on Zoom, when confined by the constraints of the COVID lockdown, we were inspired to launch new innovations. And we can even review our top songs played on Spotify because our Wrapped 2020 playlist just came out. Mine, by the way, dominated by Taylor Swift. As I look back on 2020, a very special moment for me and my wife, Mindy, was the birth of our son, Simon. Simon was born at the end of January, and we had an amazing bris ceremony at the beginning of February. It was, for Mindy and me, one of the best days of our whole lives. We were surrounded by friends and family who flew in from all over the country and Israel here to DC just to be with us and Simon. And surrounded by loved ones, including several AEPi brothers, we announced Simon's name. And then all of us there together locked arms and gave Simon a blessing for a life filled of love, community, and purpose. Looking back on that day in February, two things stand out. One, what an oasis of a day in 2020. I feel so lucky to have been able to do that in person. And the other thing that stands out really leading up to that day was the process of actually naming our baby. What a huge responsibility that was. Judaism teaches that the names we are given by our parents when we are born have a special connection directly to our souls and help shape who we become and how we live our lives. So Mindy and I took this huge responsibility very seriously. We thought about who in our family trees we wanted to honor. We made a list of all the values we wanted our child's name to represent. And we looked at lists and lists of lists of names just to find the right combination to bring all our hopes and wishes for our baby together. After all of that and our amazing day at the bris, we thought we did pretty good. But you know what's funny? As soon as we named Simon, he began to acquire new names. For instance, friends and family came up with nicknames for him right away. We put him in a crocodile outfit once, now my sister calls him Munch Munch. You know, we start with our birth names, and then over the rest of the course of our life, we pick up our nicknames and additional names. Think about it. As we grow older, we're constantly getting new names. For instance, when we were all initiated into AEPi, we earned the name of Brother. Do you remember when you were initiated into AEPi? Did having the name Brother or that title change, did it change the way you thought about yourself or thought about the other guys in your pledge class or your chapter? Names and titles can do that. They can change how we think about ourselves. And as we grow through life, they will continue to impact how we see ourselves as we gain new names or titles, such as when we become alumni or become a doctor or lawyer, or when we get married and become a husband, or when we get a job and become a manager or a director or a CEO. Sometimes we'll be the ones to give ourselves our own new names, such as if we found a company and become an entrepreneur, or when we take it upon ourselves to maybe shed a name that's been associated with us in the past, such as changing our name in order to better align with a chosen family or with a chosen religion, or if we change our names to better align with our gender identity. These names come to define who we are, how we see ourselves, and how others see us. This idea of how names affect who we are and how they can change as we grow is present in Jewish tradition in the stories of our forefathers and foremothers. For example, take Abraham's grandson and Isaac's son, Jacob. Jacob, who was born second behind his twin brother Esau, lived his whole life always trying to live up to Esau's older brother. He was born grasping at Esau's heel, trying to be the one that would be born first. Later, he schemed to win the firstborn birthright. He traded soup with Esau for it. And on his father's deathbed, Jacob put on a costume to trick his father into giving him the blessing of the firstborn. Jacob was clearly never satisfied with being the second son with that title. He was never fully comfortable with his lot in life. And in a scene that we read in this week's Torah portion, Jacob finally wrestles with his identity in order to shed himself of feeling like the second-born son, instead finally being able to live fully confident in his own shoes. The story goes that it had been many years since Jacob last saw his twin brother, and he's about to see Esau again. The night before they meet up, Jacob's sweating. He's nervous about meeting face-to-face after so many years apart, after stealing Esau's birthright. So after making preparations with his family to see Esau the next day, he settles down alone for the night. And it's during that night that the famous story of an angel coming to wrestle with Jacob occurs. All through the night, the two wrestled until dawn, at which point Jacob pins the angel. And as the sun comes up, the angel asks to be let go. And Jacob says, "I'll let you go only if you give me a blessing." So the angel blesses Jacob, and in doing so, gives him the new name of Israel, meaning one who wrestled with God and man and won. The next day, Jacob/Israel, now comfortable in his skin with his updated name, one in which he received through his own struggle with God rather than through scheming against his brother, goes to meet Esau and ultimately embraces brothers, each confident in his life. As an aside, this story is the first mention of the name Israel in the Torah, a name which we're told is about struggling with God. And as anyone who's ever been to an AEPi chapter meeting, they know that the idea of giving our community a name based on struggling resonates deeply. Anyway, the rest of Jacob's life, he goes forward with renewed confidence thanks to his new name of Israel, that knowing that he's continuing the legacy that was first handed to Abraham and then to Isaac and now to him as a forefather of a great people. Why did I bring up this story? Well, for one, it's part of this week's Parsha. That's why I'm here. And two, the story of Jacob/Israel tells us two things about names. First, the name that we're given at birth is important. It's symbolic and it's defining. And two, the way we live our life and the names we collect and are given along the way matter just as much. And sometimes a new name or title can mark a new beginning. It can help us see ourselves in a new light. It can strengthen us to navigate new situations, to overcome challenges, to get through periods of darkness and stand up to our fears. In other words, a name change or a title change can mark a point in which we change our ways. Naming my baby Simon was the culmination of a long, long process for Mindy and I. And it also gave me a new name, Dad. This year, in addition to Dad, I received another new title. When I finally shed the title of unemployed because of COVID and gained the new title of Executive Director of the Jewish Federation of Raleigh-Cary. I start in 2 weeks and I'm so excited. I am excited for that new chapter in my life as a new part of my leadership journey. And I hope to bring to it all the hopes and dreams my parents had for me when they named me Phillip Andrew. The values that were imbued in me when I became a brother of AEPi, the knowledge I gained as an alumni of UNC and later Brandeis, and the experience I gained as executive director of the D'var Project, all of which I hope to bring into this new position. Lots of new change ahead, but also for me, but also I hope for all of us. So in wrapping up here, my hope for you, Michael, for everybody watching this video, for all of AEPi, and really for everybody on planet Earth, let us all shed ourselves from the year 2020. And together, let's take on this, the new year with a new name, 2021. May 2021 be a year for all of us of new meaning, a year of healing, a year of connecting and reconnecting with friends and family and neighbors, and a year of living up to all the values and ideals that have been invested in us through our names, nicknames, and titles. I wish everybody a Shabbat Shalom, a happy Hanukkah, and the week ahead, and in only a few more weeks, a meaningful 2021. Thank you for listening today, for being here. And don't forget to tune in next week for AEPi's next weekly D'var Torah. Same AEPi time, same AEPi Facebook channel. All right, everybody. Shabbat Shalom.